lot of calculus is about understanding the qualitative features of functions. Nobody really cares about f of 17, but you might care about f of a big number qualitatively. We're going to try to make this concept of big number a bit more precise. Well, here's how we're going to get around talking about a big number. We're going to talk about a limit. To say the limit of f of x as x approaches infinity equals L means that f of x is as close as you want it to be to L, provided x is large enough. So instead of talking about just plugging in a big number, I'm going to say f at some big number, so to speak, is equal to L if I can make the output of f close to L by plugging in big enough numbers. At this point, we've seen a bunch of different definitions of limits, but they're all united by a common theme. What if someone had asked us to cook up a definition of the limit of f of x equals infinity as x goes to infinity? Could we come up with a definition for this? Yeah, absolutely we can. Here we go. The limit of f of x as x approaches infinity equals infinity means that I can make f of x as large as you want it to be, provided x is large enough. Consistently, when we're talking about infinity in limits, we're never actually talking about a specific value. We're just talking about a value which is as big as you want it to be. Let's go do an example at the blackboard. Here's a question. What's the limit of 2x over x plus 1 as x approaches infinity? Before we dive into this analytically, let's get some numerical evidence. So here's my function again, f of x equals 2x over x plus 1. I want to know qualitatively what happens when I plug in big numbers into this function. So what's, say, f of 100? Well, that's not too hard to figure out. 2 times 100 is 200, and 100 plus 1 is 101. Now, 200 divided by 101 is pretty close to 2. And there's nothing too special about 100, right? If I'd done this for a million, I would have gotten 2 million over a million and one, which would be even closer to 2. Numerically, it looks like this limit's 2, but we just figured that out by plugging in some big numbers. I want a more rigorous argument, some analytic argument that this limit is actually equal to 2. Now, how am I going to proceed? My first guess would be to use the limit law for quotients. This is the limit of a quotient, which is the quotient of limits, provided the limits exist and the limit of the denominator is non-zero. Bad news here is that the limits don't exist. The limit of the numerator is infinity, which isn't a number, so I can't use my limit law for quotients here. Instead, I'm going to sneak up on this limit problem by wearing a disguise. I'm going to multiply by a disguised version of 1. I'm going to multiply by 1 over x divided by 1 over x. Now, this is just 1. Admittedly, I have changed the function. The function's not defined anymore at 0, but for large values of x, this doesn't affect anything. And I'm taking a limit as x goes to infinity, so I only care about agreement at large values of x. I'll do some algebra. This limit is now the limit of 2x times 1 over x, which is 2, divided by the limit of x plus 1 times 1 over x, which is 1 plus 1 over x. Maybe it doesn't look like I've made a lot of progress here, but this is a huge progress. The limit of the numerator is now a number, it's 2, and the limit of the denominator is also a number, and a non-zero number at that. So I can use my limit law for quotients. This is the limit of a quotient, which is the quotient of the limit. It's the limit of 2, the numerator, divided by the limit of the denominator as x approaches infinity. The limit of the numerator is just the limit of a constant, which is 2. The limit of the denominator is the limit of a sum, which is the sum of the limits provided the limits exist. And they do. The limit of 1 is just 1. And what's the limit of 1 over x as x approaches infinity? Well, that's asking what is 1 over x close to when x is very large? Well, I can make 1 over x as close to 0 as I like if I'm willing to make x large enough. So the limit of 1 over x as x approaches infinity is 0. That means my original limit is 2 over 1 plus 0, which is 2.